this video, I'm going to show you how to hunt by the weather and how that can really impact your hunt this fall. So in this video, I have four different tips that you can use to hunt by the weather. And the buck that I just shot was because I hunted by the weather. Doubled up in school, got Thursday off. Thursday was a perfect day. 100% chance of movement all day with the hunt cast out. And that's a really good app if you haven't checked it out, and it can really help you and determine when the cold fronts are coming in. But so for the first point is cold fronts, and that can be a major movement time for deer, especially mature bucks, especially during the rut. During the rut, you need to hunt as much as you can. Now that's different with early season and late season, but in the rut, you need to still look at those cool mornings and those cold front mornings during the rut, but especially even more so in early season and late season. So cold fronts, like I said, can be a really helpful thing for when you're hunting. And like I said, the deer that I shot went out that morning, saw a doe, 6-pointer, and a 9-pointer that I drew back home, but I didn't get a shot. Went out the next night, or that night, and I shot my 10-pointer at 20 or 15 yards. So those cold fronts are really a special time to get out in the woods. Especially the first frost is a really good time to get out in the woods. And now the moon, I don't have that as a point, but the moon does not predict deer movement. The weather does. The moon can possibly, potentially sometimes make the deer go, not make them, but sometimes they'll go to food sources earlier. But you never count on the moon for defining deer movement and hunting that deer movement. And so number two is storms. And if you have a bunch of rain, a bunch of snow, stuff like that, not light snow, but like a really hard snow, where they're bedding down, and then that snow stops. The next morning, next evening when the snow stops, that's the best time to get onto your stand. Especially when it rains and thunders. They're going to be in their beds, and when it's windy, they're going to be in their beds, they're not going to be moving, and maybe those does and fawns, maybe a little bit, but not mature bucks. They will not be moving during storms. Now, light rain is fine. Deer like to move in light rain, but heavy rain, thunderstorms, they do not, and they're going to be bedded down. So if you have, say, 3 days of storming, and then Thursday morning, it all clears up, best time to go out to your stand. And because they've been hiding, or they've been being protected, they're in cover, and now they can finally come out and eat and do stuff like that and move around. So that is a really good thing. And now for number three, bedding, which I kind of already talked about with those storms. They're going to be in their beds, and especially in the late season, when it snows a lot and those heavy snows are coming down. And if the weather is kind of predicting, if you're following the weather, and if you see that snow coming down, say around 1 o'clock, they're going to be going to their beds earlier that morning. So you need to be going to a doe bedding area or a buck bedding area during those times. And so that's for number three. Now for number four, food sources and food movements. So really in late season again, or when that snow really hits hard, I have brassicas out in my plot, and those brassicas are going to start sweetening up when it gets really cold, and when that first snow comes, they're going to hit this food plot hard because all the vegetation has died in the frost, and they'll be going to those food sources. And if you have ag fields, maybe not ones that are already cut, but like they took out our beans and they planted winter wheat, which I'm really glad that they did, because that'd be great to do shotgun weekend, and our second shotgun weekend. We just had shotgun weekend just this last weekend. But really focus on food in the evening. You should see a more evening movement when in late season. But overall, hunting by the weather is really crucial to how you hunt, and that can really lead to a lot of mature buck success.